Hello there and welcome. In this video we're going to see how to create an opposite accounting entry in Excel using Excel Power Query and the Excel data model. So the first thing we're going to do to hold our database is create a new Excel file. So let's just go to our search bar and type Excel to find the Excel app. So now we're going to save the file. I'm just going to save it in my desktop and call it database all companies. I always use the same name for my Excel file because I only use Excel file for absolutely everything, and that's this file that contains millions of rows and hundreds of tables. I click save. So now the first thing I want is my general ledger codes because I want to see what codes I must use on my bank statement. So I'm going to import the general ledger codes templates. I'm going to go data from text CSV. I'm going to go with all my documents are. Then I'm going to search for the general ledger codes. You'll see that my file names have got public before. I don't want to give a long explanation now, but I use SQL, so I export my files from SQL and it adds the name public according to your database setup in PostgreSQL. Alright, so we've got our general ledger codes. So let's just go and change it so we only have the columns that we require. So let's just go and transform data. So we're going to need the ID, we need the category 1, 2, 4, the general ledger itself, and then category 3. So we right click, remove other columns. Let's just put them in nice order. Make sure our data types are correct. ID must always be a whole number, that's correct. This is text, so we're happy. So we're going to close and load it to our worksheet. Existing worksheet, I always choose B1. Click OK. So in order to create an opposite entry on our bank statement, we've got the one side allocated, which I'll show you now when I upload the bank statement. And then the other side has to go to the bank account, because in accounting entry, you've got the one side, example, if it's bank charges, the one entry is going to debit bank charges and then credit at the bank. So we need to find the bank general ledger. So let's go and find the bank general ledger code in our templates. Bank. So our general ledger code is 167, so we'll keep that in the back of our mind. So let's go and import our bank statement that we want to create our opposite entry. Again, data, text CSV, search the bank statements. Open. Again, let's only use the columns we're going to require for this video. So we're going to need the ID of the bank statement, the date, the memo, the amount, and then we need the general ledger where it's been allocated to. Right click, remove other columns. Alright, so we've got one side of the general ledger entry, the other side has to be 167, remember to go to the bank account. So what we're going to do, we're going to add a column, and we're going to add a column that's opposite of this amount to create the opposite entry for a start. Let's go add column, custom column, let's call it opposite amount. It's going to be the opposite of the amount column. Click OK. Change the data type, it must be the same as this one, so it's got to be decimal, so right click. change type, decimal number. Let's just put the mouse next to each other, so let's just move this column to the end. So now we're going to combine these columns together, and it's going to say amount and opposite amount in one column with amounts in one column. I'll show you what I mean now. So I'm select the two amounts, right click, unpivot columns. So they've all been unpivoted now. So we've got the amount and the opposite amount. So let's just change this column name to amount. The data type's right, it's decimal. So now we're going to create another column. We want to say if the amount's opposite amount, it must equal the general ledger code ID. And if it's only the amount, then it must equal our bank code, general ledger code 167. So let's go and do that. We're going to create a conditional column. Let's just leave it at custom for now. So we're going to say if the attribute is equal to amount, then it must be our general ledger code 167. Otherwise, must equal the column general ledger code ID. So we click OK. So now we've got our general ledger code, our new general ledger code ID with the opposite entries brought into our database. So we don't need this code anymore. Let's go and delete this. Remove. We don't need the attribute anymore. Let's go and remove that. Let's go and change this name to general ledger code ID. Types got to be a whole number because it's only numbers in here. So we right click, change type, whole number. Okay, all our types are right. IDs, whole number, date is dates. This is a text, decimal number, whole number. So let's just go and I always like the amounts to be at the end. I don't know why, it just suits me better. So now we're ready to add this to our data model. So we're just going to go, let's just change this name to bank statements. We'll just call it general ledger now because now it's been changed. So this is our general ledger. So now we're going to load it to our data model. Close and load to. Only create connection because we don't need the data itself. Add to data model. Click OK. Gonna be a couple of 100,000 entries. Okay, we don't worry about the errors. I know what they are. They're minor. So we've got 314,000 loaded to our data model. So if we go to our data model, we go to Power Pivot, Excel data model, manage. Diagram view. There's our general ledger now we've created with the opposite entry. So now we want to, let's go and look at the data view. So it's 314,000 lines. So now we need the general ledger codes added to our Excel data model as well, so we can connect them and create our general ledger. So we're going to go to edit the general ledger codes. We're going to load it to the data model. Add it to the data model. Only create connection because we don't need the data. Click OK. Don't worry about the error. So we've got our two tables which we need in our Excel data model. So if we go to our Excel data model again now. Power Pivot, Excel data model. We're going to look at diagram view. We've got our general ledger codes, our template, and we've got our general ledger which we created with the opposite entries. So now we want to join these together. So the ID, the general ledger code ID, must be connected to the public general ledger code. So let's just move our transaction table, as I call it. We're going to create a join just by dragging this across, And we've got our join ready to create a report now from our general ledger. So let's go and create the report. Let's go and select B1. Insert pivot table from our data model, because we loaded our everything to the data model. Existing worksheet, click OK. So now we're gonna load our, let's first go and load the amount. Drag it down. Change the top, value field settings, number format, and make it accounting currency. Click OK. So you can see our general ledger balance, because the total is null. So we already know we're on the right track. So let's go and choose our categories from our general ledger code table. So we don't need, we're happy now, our accounts balance. So we don't need the grand total. Let's go and take this out. Grand total, off for rows and columns. So let's go and select the second category. So let's put subtotal so we can see all the time that our books balance, because assets must always equal to equity and liability. So let's go subtotal, show at the top of the group. So we can see we're still balancing. Let's go and add the third category from our general ledger codes template. There's our statement of financial position. Let's just put this in the correct area. The equity we want before the liabilities. It's just the way financial statements work. So they are nice financial statements. So now we could add more categories if we want. If we want to really split it out, see the breakdown. Could add the general ledger code itself. Right, so we're really expanding our data. But the one problem we've got, we haven't got the financial year. So the way to do that is you go to Power Pivot, go to Excel data model, diagram view, design, date table. It's always better to create a date table separately for performance purposes. And it's always better to have your data in before you create the date table, so it's got a history to work on it to create the correct dates. So you go date table, new. We connect it to our general ledger because that's what we want to work with in our report. The date column of the general ledger will be connected to the date column of the calendar. Now we haven't got a financial year column in our calendar, so we're going to create one now using calculated columns. So we go home, data view, because we want to work on our tables itself. So we've got three tables now, three in our data model, three connecting tables, as we saw from the diagram view, with the general ledger codes, the calendar, and we've got the general ledger itself. So back to data view. So let's put a formula in here, equals if. So we're going to say if the calendar month number is less than 3, then it must equal the calendar year. Otherwise must be equal to the calendar year plus 1. Close the formula, enter. So we can see our financial year is now correct. If it's March, it moves on one to 2008, because we got our financial year ending February every year in this company. So we rename the column. Let's call it financial year. So let's go and see our diagram view. We can see what financial year added. It's all the tables are connected. Let's go and add our financial year to our report. So click in the report. Let's go to our field list. Let's go and find the financial year. Let's bring it in. So now we've got our financial year brought in. Let me just change the options here so it doesn't keep expanding automatically. So let's just right click, pivot table options, not, mustn't auto fit, because must stay with our columns that we want all the time. Also, we want zeros in between wherever they're blank. So click inside the pivot table, right click, pivot table options for empty cells show zero, just to make it a bit neater. Right. So now we want to change our total. The running totals must be add up per year. So right click and in these totals, anyone, right click, show values as running total financial year. So you choose the financial year, click OK. Let's just double click all these columns so they open, expand to show all the figures. So there we have our financial year insert into our table. We've got our general ledger, or it's actually the statement of financial position, but from this you can generate profit and loss or statement of changes in equity or anything. And there's only once your setup process. So as you add more bank statements to your external file, this will update automatically. So if you're like me, I think you'll be amazed by what Excel can do. And it can handle unlimited amounts of data, unlimited different companies, unlimited bank statement entries. And it can be expanded if you... Now, this was only the bank statement, so you can add your bills from your suppliers. You can add your journals. You can add your customer invoices. So you have your whole accounting system on this one Excel file. It can accommodate any number of companies, and you know, you can import it to your accounting system as well once you're happy that your reports look correct in your Excel file. So that's about all for this video. If you like what you see, please click the like button below, subscribe to receive any new videos I make, share with anybody that you might feel have need, please, and thank you for watching.